yourself, Bob. You follow her to work. You eavesdrop on her calls. You open her mail. The minute you started doing these things, the relationship was over. Thank you for your call. Roz, I think we have time for one more.
Yes, Dr. Crane. On line four, we have Russell from Kirkland.
Hello, Russell. This is Dr. Frasier Crane. I'm listening.
Well, I've been feeling sort of, you know, depressed lately. My life's not going anywhere. It's not that bad. It's just same old apartment, same old job. Sometimes
Russell,
just...
we're just about at the end of our hour. Let me see if I can cut to the chase by using myself as an example. 6 months ago, I was living in Boston. My wife had left me, which was very painful. Then she came back to me, which was excruciating. On top of that, my practice had grown stagnant, and my social life consisted of, well, hanging around a bar night after night. You see, I was clinging to a life that wasn't working anymore, and I knew I had to do something, anything. So I ended the marriage once and for all, packed up my things, and moved back here to my hometown of Seattle. Go Seahawks. I took action, Russell, and you can too. Move, change, do something. If it's a mistake, do something else. Will you do that, Russell? Will you? Russell, I think we lost him.
No, we cut to the news 30 seconds ago.
For crying out loud. I finally bare my soul to all of Seattle, and they're listening to Chopper Dave's Rush Hour Roundup. Well, the rest of the show was pretty good. It was a good show, wasn't it?
Here, your brother called.
Roz, in the trade, we call that avoidance. Don't change the subject. Tell me what you think.
Do I ever tell you what this little button does?
I am not a piece of Lalique. I can handle criticism. How was I today?
Let's see. You dropped two commercials. You left a total of 28 seconds of dead air. You scrambled the station's call letters. You spilled yogurt on the control board, and you kept referring to Jerry with the identity crisis as Jeff.
You say my brother called. Mm-hmm.
So I said to the gardener, Yoshi, I do not want a Zen garden in my backyard. If I want to rake gravel every 10 minutes to maintain my inner harmony, I'll move to Yokohama. Well, this offends him, so he starts pulling up Maris's prized camellias by the handful. Well, I couldn't stand for that, so I marched right into the morning room and locked the door until he cooled down. Tell me you would have handled it differently, Frasier.
Oh, I'm sorry, Niles. I didn't realize you'd stop talking.
You haven't heard a word I said.
Oh, Niles, you're a psychiatrist. You know what it's like to listen to people prattling on endlessly about their mundane lives.
Touché. And on that subject, I heard your show today.
And?
You know what I think about pop psychiatry.
Yes, I know what you think about everything. When was the last time you had an unexpressed thought?
I'm having one now.
You guys ready?
Two cafe latte supremos.
No, thank you.
So, Frasier, how are you doing on your own?
I'm fine. I love my new life. I love the solitude. I miss Frederick like the dickens, of course. You know, he's quite a boy. He's playing goalie on the Pee Wee soccer team now. Chip off the old block.
You hated sports.
So does he. The fresh air is good for him.
Oh, well, this has been fun, Frasier, but we have a problem, and that's why I thought we should talk.
Is it Dad?
Afraid so. One of his old buddies from the police force called this morning. He went over to see him and found him on the bathroom floor.
Oh, my God.
No, it's okay. He's fine.
What, is his hip again?
Frasier, I don't think he can live alone anymore.
What can we do?
Well, I know this isn't going to be anyone's favorite solution, but I took the liberty of checking out a few convalescent homes for him.
Well, Niles, a home? He's still a young man.
Well, you certainly can't take care of him. You're just getting your new life together.